Ladies and gentle bitches, finally the day has come where I can stop torturing myself. The entire 2019, the entire year, I have not listened to one single Harry Styles song. Not a single one. People were flipping out when Lights Up came out, didn't listen to it. Video came out, people lost their shit. Did not watch it. Watermelon Sugar, people were flipping out about that. Didn't listen to the leaks. If there even was any, I wouldn't know. Would not even know. The entire, Adore You, didn't listen to it. I avoided every single thing on Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat, Reddit, Twitch, whatever you people do nowadays. I avoided all of it. Didn't listen to a single thing. Single thing. I have no idea what to expect coming into this album. But okay, first of all, for everyone who is subscribed, welcome back. My name is Troy. I go by HTHAZE. Thank you so much for coming in and, you know, plopping down in your seat. Maybe get like a meal prepared, you know, whatever you're doing to watch this video. I know a lot of you guys have probably been waiting for a video like this. I'm sorry it took so long, but I was just waiting for this little bitch to drop his shit, and he finally did it, so here we are. If you don't know who Harry Styles is, you must be living under a rock, as they say, or at least a very deep hole. This man was part of One Direction. He is a light to many people's worlds. He is respected among LGB community. The straights love him too. And I think he's just a very well-rounded individual. I'm super excited to listen to this. I've been waiting for his album since One Direction came out. I knew he was gonna pop off and be his own thing. I mean, look at the man, he's gorgeous. I mean, look at him. He's got the voice of an angel as well. How can you not pursue a solo music career, right? Gonna have the list of the songs right here so you guys can stay along with me if you wanna listen or whatever. The video's gonna be chopped up. And I wanna address something that I saw in the comments of a few of my other videos. People saying that I listened to like 30 seconds of the song and then I skip it. I don't. I listen to the whole thing. I just don't have that much of a reaction for the whole thing, so I just give you guys like the best bits. Don't think that I'm skipping through these. I listen to the entire album. That's it. Let's get this thing going, baby. Also, what y'all think about the merch? More on that later. Okay. Here we go. Fine Line, Harry Styles. First song, Golden. I love the realness. Like, he's using real instruments. I can tell. Oh yeah, that slide. Get that slide, baby. Oh, yes. Pen, baby. Pen. I don't want to be alone either, bro. Okay, first song, I love it. Real instruments, love that vibe. I can tell that he's probably gonna be having a band that's pretty consistent with all of these songs, just because I feel like he tours with a band that's fairly consistent as well. Wow, awesome. Four writers on that song. Four. You hear that, Ariana Grande? Does not take 11 writers. Does not take 11 writers. No shade on Ariana, but it's nice. It's refreshing when you see, like, I mean, the first thing that pops into my mind when I see that four writers in a room is friends writing a song, you know? It's not a corporate, it's not a team of people. It's people who have like-minded, you know, thoughts, and they come together and they're writing a song. But okay, next one, Watermelon Sugar.
Tastes like strawberries on a summer evening.
Oh, this is the exact vibe that oh my god.
Like song.
It is. That guitar is so funky. Oh my god.
Sugar high.
those horns, baby. Oh, you hear that little vocal in the back? That's tight. Wow. Dude, it's so funky. And I was kind of expecting, you know, like a definitely like a funkier David Bowie almost-esque kind of like vibe with this album. But that guitar was funky, bro. Oh my God. Same four writers. Crazy. Love it. Next one, Adore You. So this came out before. Or I guess both of them did. That falsetto, okay, Harry. It's definitely more of like a pop vibe for this one. Oh wow. Oh wow. Oh wow. Dude, his vocals are ooh. It's the fruits, baby. Ooh. Ooh, a guitar solo? Y'all know how I feel about that. Wow. Wow, dude. Okay, so that one I can definitely see on the radio. If that's not getting airtime in 2020, it should, dude. Wow. I mean, he's bringing back the 70s, like, pop rock vibe, which is really, really cool. And you kind of get that from, like, his whole, like, persona. And I know I've seen him and the Fleetwood Mac singer, I'm blanking on the name, Stevie Nicks, on stage. And I know he's like very well respected in the UK sphere of that genre of music, so that's really cool. Man, the harmonies on that, like, oh my God, dude. I really love when singers perfect their melodies to a point where it gives the song a certain texture that you'll never get with anybody else, because it is their voice, and their voice has different intricacies. And Harry has really perfected that. It's crazy because it just comes in time, you know? And I can kind of hear, you know, my favorite One Direction songs, you know, in my head. And I can kind of see now which boy had the influence in the songs. Like, I can kind of tell that Fireproof was kind of Harry and Niall now, you know? And that's just so cool. Wow. Wow, really cool. Okay, next one is called Lights Up. This one was the one that came out and everyone was flipping out about the video and it's sexy and yeah, okay. Here we go, Lights Up. I just love the fact that he has the guitar in there. That's great, I love that. I know he plays too, so good on you, Harry. Harmonies, bro. Oh, chords. Oh, I love that major. That's so nice. Oh, that feels so good. Again. Yeah, oh man, he has something with this one, dude. This is good, dude. Man. Oh my God. A lot of really cool textures in that, man. Dude, that choir. Shut it, shut it. Oh, that was so dope. What? See, that's what you get when you get a man who has like been born into the pop industry, and then you take what he really loves deep down, and you fucking. He's sculpting a sound that nobody else is really doing right now, and that's exactly what he needs to do. I stan. How can you not, you know? Jeez. Next one is called Cherry. I'm getting a lot of fruit vibes. Maybe that might be like a sexual thing. I hope so. Oh my god, this acoustic texture is so nice. Come on, Harry, come on, bring it in. Don't you call him baby. Oh my god, oh my god. Oh, this is my favorite so far. What is that? Is that a violin or something? Or like a cello? Oh, I love the harmonica! Did you know I still talk to them? Does he take you walking around his pain? Yeah! Bring him bitches in, bro! Pipes! God. Bro, he's got pipes for days. Oh, what's happening? Oh, shit. Aw. Who is that speaking French? It's alright, we don't have any time. Next one is called Falling. Cherry was so good. Oh my god. You have to listen to headphones, guys. If you are listening, you have to listen to headphones. That is just such a beautiful atmosphere. Holy shit. I'm in my bed. I wish I could be, bro. And there's no one to blame. I'll cuddle you. I can unpack the baggage left. Pen, bro. Pen. What am I now? What if I'm down? What if I'm out? What if I'm so falling again? I'm falling. Oh my god, kids calling me. Jeez. Buying a lamp. I'm sorry, Harry. I'm sorry. Back to falling. Falling in love with this man. Am I right? Wow. He is stretching his voice so much. That is... I expect nothing less. Wow. Falling again, falling. You know, he knows how to pull on the little heartstrings, you know? He really knows how to put his heart and soul into a song. Or at least he really knows how to make it sound like that. And you cannot say that about a whole lot of artists. You really, really can't. So he's brought it down a little bit. We're chilling out just a touch. And I think we're gonna get even sadder to be so lonely. Here we go. Oh my god, I love this. Oh, the ukulele or the Spanish guitar. I was just a little boy. Oh, that's so cute. I love that. Oh, I love the instrumentation of this. It's so raw. I like that line. Dude, whatever that like nylon string instrument is so cool to have. And I love the way that he's singing each individual line. You just don't hear it. You just don't hear it nowadays. At least not from like big pop stars, you know? I'm really happy that he's exploring like every facet of his personality. And I can really tell that like going through the album. And we're a little over halfway done. This next song is called She, and it's 6 minutes. Also, I just wanna say, every song is using roughly the same instruments, which is something that a lot of bands do. A lot of bands also did back in like the 80s and the 70s and like early 90s and whatnot. Synthesizers and productions didn't really get into like mainstream music, like mainstream music until like a little bit later. But that is really, really cool, and I appreciate it that he has instrumentalists working behind the scenes for every single thing. Very cool. Oh, that's a weird sound. That's weird. That's weird. Ooh, that like middle range vocal? Oh my god. I haven't like heard this from him. Oh my gosh, that vocal tone is so different from what all the other songs are. That's really cool. That is really cool.
Holy crap, it's already been like 4 minutes. That's crazy. The song carries very well. Keep that fucking guitar solo going, baby. Alright, how's he gonna fade it out? I like the bah, 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 bah. I'm always a big fan of band hits. Wow. Okay, so that was really, really cool. That carried 6 minutes very easily. I think that guitar solo was probably the main factor in that. I was getting a lot of Awaken My Love vibes. I would love to hear like an entire album like that from Harry. But wow. Moving on. Sunflower, Volume 6. I don't know why it's called Volume 6. Where's 5, 4, 3, 2, 1? Are we gonna get them eventually? I don't know, probably not. But let's check it out. Oh, I like it already.
Sunflower.
Ooh. Whoa.
Sunflower.
Oh! Oh, that melody is so good.
That's such a dope switch up!
Oh, dude.
I mean, this is just David Bowie and Queen. Like, love child.
Oh my god, there's a guitar in the left ear that's just like, fucking going down and shit.
Oh, that's so cool.
He's just having fun, man. Oh my god! Okay, I love that so much because, I mean, it's very, oh my god, this is so, I'm gonna try to explain this in a way that makes sense. The kind of genre of music that that he is building right now is very reminiscent of the 70s, and a lot of times what these artists did is they just, I mean, frankly, they just got high as fuck in the studio and started making music, and they just started saying like, oh hey, this would sound really cool, you know, I can play this instrument differently, I can do something different with this, you know, collab in a way that's different than something I've heard before. And he's really taking that to heart, and that's so just refreshing to hear that kind of process still exists in a way that you can do a different genre with it. So it's, I don't know if anything I'm saying makes sense. It makes sense in my head, I don't know. Comment below if you think it makes sense, or I'd love to hear everybody's opinion of the album down in the comments. So thank you so much. Also, while you're down there, hit the thumbs up button and subscribe if you haven't already. I got a bunch of new music coming out, as well as hopefully more reaction videos of some of y'all's favorites. Thank you so much. While you're down there, you know, do your boy a favor. I'll stay up here playing this next motherfucking song, Canyon Moon. Oh, yes, baby. Oh, yeah. Oh, yes. Woo. Those bongos, baby. Bongo me against a wall, am I right?
I heard Jenny saying,
what'd she say, bro?
Go get the kids from school.
Okay. Oh yes, that walk down. You walk down that fucking chord, baby. Oh, that was... Oh yes! Oh, that is so beautiful. Oh my god. I just have to mention that. The chords go down, but his repeated melody and vocals go up. Good shit. Oh, that's so fun. Oh my god. That's just
Maybe we can find a place to feel good, and we can treat people with kindness. Find a place to feel good. I got a
okay.
Good feeling.
Okay. Yes. Ooh!
So that was different. Who the fuck was that Sound of Music ass bitch singing the chorus? There's some there's a lyric in there that I really like. Giving second chances, I don't need all the answers. Feeling good in my skin, I just keep on dancing. I can see those tattoos right now. Treat people with kindness. Amen. And unfortunately, this is the last song. It's called Fine Line. And honestly, I have enjoyed this album. I have been thoroughly impressed, and I have enjoyed this album. This is not my genre of music. I don't really listen to this kind of music a lot. I can appreciate the old stuff. But hearing this in 2019 with the twist and the production and Harry being Harry and all that, I am really impressed. Let's get to this last song, Fine Line. Here we go. It's very atmospheric. This is definitely like the ending song. Dude, I love that his vocals are panned. And the fact that they're not flawless is also really, really nice. He has been a sad boy this album, man. I like the Bon Iver horns. I call those Bon Iver horns, chords, horns, whatever. They are chords, but they are also horns. Ooh, those drums are... They almost sounded off for a second, but they're not. They're not. Oh, yeah. Oh, that's nice. Those band hits are something else, man. Wow. Single piano chord. Wow. Wow. Okay. That's it. That's the whole album. Start to finish. Fine Line by Harry Styles. Wow. All right. I said this before. This is not the kind of genre that I listen to a whole lot. It is considered pop music, but that's just because Harry Styles is a pop icon. If I had to put this into a different genre, I would definitely, well, I don't know about a genre, but I would definitely put it in with some of the 70s rock, like alternative, almost country-ish vibes. He utilizes an acoustic guitar very well, and I think he knows that his voice resonates very well acoustically. And to know that about your sound, you level up, you know, you're already a step ahead for concerts, for live events, you know, whatever you're doing. He's got his finger on the pulse of his sound, and that's so key for an artist. I'm just so impressed. You can really tell that he's sculpting an experience with this album. You know, these are all songs that I feel like could be played in a row at a concert. He could perform this entire album live and present it in a DVD or in a, you know, some whatever iTunes or Spotify does now. And it would work flawlessly. So wow, he really has sculpted a sound and an atmosphere with his music. Respect. Respect to the producers who see his vision as a creative. I can't wait to see more. I'm gonna go watch the music videos now, off camera, so I can really enjoy it. Thank you so much for hanging out with me, listening to the new Harry Styles album. If you liked it, give us a thumbs up. Subscribe down below. You know, I'm an artist myself, and I like to keep the motto, don't sleep on smaller artists. But with Harry Styles, he's kind of an international heartthrob pop superstar. So I understand the feelings towards him. But yes, smaller artists also exist. Hope you enjoyed the reaction. Go listen to some of my music. Go listen to the new Harry Styles album if you haven't already. Download it on Spotify, Apple Music, whatever you do. Follow me on social media. Links down below, HTHAZE. If you like this merch and you want to see more HTHAZE merch, head on over to my Instagram to see some of the stuff that we've been working on. And that is truly it. Go live your life. Have a beautiful day. Beautiful weekend, wherever you are in the world. Thank you so much, and I'll see you soon. Peace.